Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of Rotter Tube Reef. So I did a pre-video on what I'm going to do today. I'm not going to edit this video at all. I'm just going to sit with you guys, get this video out, talk, tell you what I'm going to do. I did a pre-video yesterday to let you know what I'm going to do in this tank today. A little experiment. I got a lot of people who said, yeah, let's try it. I got some other people that were like, don't do it. And I even got someone who said, I'm unsubscribing. Okay. And I got another person who said, you're only doing this for the views, to get more popular. No. Any of you guys who know me know that I could care less, or couldn't care less, what people think. This isn't for the views. You know, my whole channel is based on experimentation and tons of research. I just don't go into things blindly, haphazardly. I don't do that, right? So this has to do with like ick in your tank. And so here's a long story short of it. I want to give you guys, oh, hold on a second. Hey boy. Ooh, Jack came to say hi. Jack came to say hi. He's doing pretty good. He wasn't. Really wasn't for a while there, but he's still with us, doing really well. Okay. How do I start this out? I think a handful of people misunderstood what's happening here. I've got videos on this, so watch them for more information, because I don't want to turn this into a whole big lesson thing. Okay. Let me back way up. When you get a new fish or new coral or an invert from the reef store, you don't ever put it right in your tank. Because if that water, more than likely, will contain parasites or disease. Okay, because their whole store is connected to one filtration system. And you know how you see one fish and you're like, oh, I want that one in that tank. I'll buy him. I'm not going to buy this guy in this tank up here around the corner because he's scraping himself along the ground. It looks like he's diseased. He's half dead already. Well, guess what? Whatever disease he has that's in his water is in the same tank that you're looking at to purchase because it's all one filtration system in that store. You know how expensive it would be to have a filtration system for every little tank they have in that store? Okay, now that we have that out of the way, you buy that fish, you bring it home, you put it in your tank, guess what? Disease will spread. There's a problem called ick parasite, which my channel is based on, and marine velvet. It kills your fish really fast. And people who say that once you have ick in your tank, you always have ick in your tank, that's wrong. Check out my videos, how to eradicate it. Also check the video description for my book I wrote. It's on Amazon, it's like a couple bucks. It's like 60 pages. I go through every single thing you need to do in depth on how to eradicate the ick parasite and marine velvet forever from your tank. And that's partly what I'm talking about today. So you bring that fish home. You don't put it in here. You get another tank if you have just like little fish like Nemos, clownfish, Acellaris, whatever you want to call them. You're going to put them in a quarantine tank with salt water. Make sure that tank has gone through the process of cycling, so it's got bacteria in it. Takes about a month or so. My book talks about that. I've got other videos on that as well. Check them out. And you're going to put just a little dose of cupramine. This is a bottle I keep on hand for friends in case they have ick breakout parasite. This stuff kills the ick parasite, and it also kills your coral, and it also kills your inverts, so you never ever ever want to dose this in your main tank. Alright? It kills corals almost instantly and inverts, snails, all that. Which brings us to the experiment I'm going to do in just a minute. So you're going to dose this. Now, the directions tell you how much to dose for how many gallons of water you have. Dosing the recommended dose is near toxic levels for your fish. All right. So I always cut that in half and it works fine. I haven't had to use this in a a long time. I haven't had ick in my tank. The fish never showed signs of ick. They don't have any white spots on them. They don't scrape against the sand. This tank is totally fine. Now, when you buy coral and inverts, snails, crabs, whatever, shrimp, you want to put them in a separate quarantine tank, number two, because you don't dose this stuff in there. It will kill those guys instantly, pretty much, all right? So you just want to keep them in salt water only for 6 weeks. The fish quarantine tank, 6 weeks with a half a dose of this copper, and the second quarantine tank with no copper for your inverts for 6 weeks. After 6 weeks, they look good. You can take them out and put them in. It's like a holding tank to make sure and cleanse the fish and make sure the parasites are gone. So one side note, on that second tank with your inverts and your coral, how do the parasites die if they're in that water if you don't use this? Well, it's easy. Those parasites and disease feed on fish. If there's no fish in that tank, the parasites are going to die. They don't feed on coral or snails or inverts. So now that we have that out of the way, this stuff is dangerous, as I've said. And people have asked me, which this is leading up into this experiment, how do I get the fish out of my quarantine tank with the net if the net touches my water in the main tank? What if there's a little bit of copper? Some people freak out, all right, because you might get a little bit of copper in this tank, like an eighth of a drop or a sixteenth of a drop. Now, other people say any amount of copper in here, and this is all over the web, by the way. If you put copper in this main tank, your corals and inverts will die. We've got that squared away. Well, there's no corals and inverts in this tank, and I wouldn't recommend this test on your own. If something happens, it's not my fault. It's up to you, as with anything on this channel. So what I'm going to do, because people say that copper, once it's in your main tank, it stays in your rocks and it stays in your sand pretty much forever, and it continually will leach out into your main tank and kill all inverts and coral that you put into it. Fish are fine. I mean, they don't. This stuff is fine as long as you don't OD them. They'll die. It'll kill their nervous system if they OD on this. That's why I dose half of the amount. By the way, there's copper test kits to see how much is in the water. It's almost impossible to test for. You read up on it. The testing that's available out there, it doesn't do that good of a job. So anyway, people, if they've used this stuff in the main tank, or they accidentally dosed it in the main tank, or they got a drop in their main tank, or they used equipment from their main tank, from their quarantine tank in the main tank, which you should never do, they're afraid the copper is going to infect this. Now that we've got that squared away, long story short, it's been said that you can never put coral in this tank again. So what I'm going to do, because there's no coral in here, let me say, if there was coral in here or inverts, I wouldn't be doing this because it would kill them. The point of this test is to put copper solution, cupramine, in this tank when there's no coral and no inverts. Let it in there for 6 weeks. I'm going to put a full dose in this, or half a dose in this tank. Let it go through its 6 week structure. That means 6 weeks of water changes. Maybe I'll go 8. I don't know how long it'll take to clear. Maybe 3 months, maybe 6 months. I think one of my subscribers said that the manufacturer says that your tank will be clear of this copper solution in 6 to 8 months. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a coral, put it in a quarantine tank for 6 weeks, taking care of those parasites, if there's any, and more than likely there are, from the fish store. Dose this right now in here, a half a dose roughly. 5 drops will take care of the experiment fine. After 6 weeks of water changes and the protein skimmer going, we're going to see if what they say is true. I'm going to see how well the coral survive, and I bet they survive just fine, along with the inverts that I put in here. The point of this is to see if the copper actually does leach out of the rocks. I'm not just going to buy coral today and throw them in here with a dose of copper solution. That would be stupid. So let's get it straight. That's not... The test isn't to see how fast corals die when you put this in here. You guys have misunderstood. I'm putting this in here without any coral. Can't stress that enough. It's like people weren't understanding. No coral, no inverts, just fish. By the way, if you never have any plans on putting corals or inverts in here, or cleanup crew, starfish, whatever, you could dose this in your main tank if you get an ick outbreak. That would be totally ideal. Because if you do get an ick outbreak, all these fish have to come out. Because as long as there's a fish hiding in there, the parasites will continue to feed and they'll continue to multiply, and it's going to get worse and worse. Feeding garlic doesn't help, by the way. We all know that. So let me put this in here. Do you guys understand what's going on? I'm dosing this with nothing in here but fish. After 6 weeks, I'll put coral in here to see how well the coral reacts. With my luck, the coral will die because the water parameters were off. But I doubt that's going to happen. So let me move this over. Get a look at these pretty fish. Look at them. I got to scrape the back off. There's algae on it. So I'm not going to stand here and measure drops. It's like 120 drops of this stuff in my tank. By the way, there have been a handful of subscribers that reached out to me and they said that they've done this and there's no problems with their coral. One, two, three, four, five. You know what? I'm not going to do drop. I'm just going to do a squirt and a squirt. That's going to be like a lot. Hopefully you guys saw that. So there's like copper in the tank currently. We're going to give this 6 weeks. Let you guys watch the fish as we go. God, look at them, how beautiful they look. Now remember, this won't hurt the fish. I'm going to let this copper cycle through the tank. It's going to get in the rocks, the sand everywhere in the tank. One drop of this stuff, people have said that it will kill coral. Well, I just put a handful of drops and two squeeze bottles full in here. If I didn't want coral in this tank, and if there was an ick outbreak, which there won't be, this will not be a problem. Because it doesn't kill fish unless you put way too much in. So that's it, you guys. I hope you understood what I'm going for here. I'll be giving updates on this. This isn't for views. It's ridiculous. This is just to bust the myth. Again, after 6 to 8 weeks when I put coral in here, if it works, do this at your own discretion. I'm not going to be responsible. I'm just doing like a little test here, okay? Just to see what happens. And just because it'll be successful in my tank doesn't mean it would be successful in your tank. It's just something I wanted to see for myself. I'm going to start with a frog spawn probably and star polyp coral. So that's it. If this video has upset you guys in any way, I apologize, but this is, channel is mainly for me and to share the knowledge that I know. This isn't for views or ratings. I don't care about that. I have other ways of making money. Alright guys, have a great weekend. I'll talk to you later. Thanks for subscribing and thanks for watching. Alright? Have a great weekend. And I'll see you later. Oh, by the way, all haters, comments will be removed because I'm not dealing with that on the channel here. Oh, it looks like bicolor blenny is getting attacked by the clownfish. Leave him alone. Those pair of clownfish up in the upper right-hand corner, this has been their tank for the longest time. So sometimes when, I was going to say when people, when fish go to their corner, they kind of don't like it. They just give them a little warning. Now, on a side note, this Harlequin Sweet Lips fish is getting a little bigger. He's increased in size by 50%. He was a smaller guy. When I got him, he was like an inch and a half long. He's easily 2.5 inches now. He's growing well and he's eating like a fiend. That fish is going to grow big. This dude is going to grow big. Like 2 feet long big. But that's not going to happen for a while. In fact, on a side note here, I was doing some reading. A lot of people can't keep these guys successfully because they don't eat. This guy eats like a beast. He's totally fine. And I read that a couple people, after 4 years, the fish is only like 8 inches long, which is about the size of my guy right there, the Fowlery Tang. So we got 4 to 5 years with the Harlequin Sweet Lips there easily. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later. Sorry for the babble, but I just didn't want to edit this video in any way. Have a great weekend, and thanks for watching, and check out our Facebook group. Links in the video description below to everything I use on Amazon and our awesome Facebook group. Over 800 members so far. Take care, and have a good one.